And the mother of a baby who died when exhaust fumes leaked into the family car is calling for mandatory safety checks on second-hand vehicles. She hopes her tragedy serves as a warning to others about a silent killer. Reporter Jayne Stinson with this exclusive interview.
As Ika Windiati grieves the heartbreaking loss of her 8-month-old son, Ibrahim, she finds some comfort in the fact she's expecting another baby.
I lost my son, but I will get another one. Yeah, hopefully it will help me to release this feeling.
Ika felt dizzy and passed out while driving her two children at Hilton on Friday, waking to news she couldn't believe her baby son was dead.
Maybe it's just dreaming, I said. Maybe it's just dreaming.
Ika and her unborn child survived, along with her 7-year-old daughter, Fatima. In just a few minutes, toxic fumes had filled the car, seeping in through worn seals. Ika and her husband bought the 1998 Ford Falcon station wagon just 8 months ago, a larger car in preparation for Ibrahim's arrival. And they've had it serviced 3 times.
We don't have a really serious problem with our car. It's very go smoothly.
They're now calling for mandatory safety checks when second-hand cars are sold.
Every second-hand car that bought by someone should have checked.
The proposal is being considered.
So it has got some merit to it, but it'll have to be done under some very strict conditions.
It's an awful tragedy. If there's anything that we could do to prevent that, we'd like to try and find a way of making sure that this never happens again.
Ika hopes her tragedy serves as a warning so no other family has to endure what hers has. Jayne Stinson, 10 News.